deadline. Same time every day if we don't meet it. The paper goes out anyway, we still got so much layout to do. How will I fill page 7x2? We give it our lives so we don't have to socialize.
Making up quotes won't do any harm.
Picture of Fernand with a dick on his arm.
These hot presses make my blood start to flow.
And if I didn't work for the spec, come tonight, where would I go?
Genetically altered super babies colonize Upper West Side. Now that's a headline.
I got a headline for you. New taco shop opens in weeks.
No, no! Mexican invaders pillage East Campus. You gotta pack a punch, kid.
You see, it's my job to keep this place running smooth, and so sometimes you gotta bend the truth. Don't call it lying. It's just what we do.
Call me Ace around here, cause I'm smarter than sin. I'll make the paper great, the rest of them just fill it in. Story after story I break. I can't help but wonder if I'll ever make a dumb mistake.
On the men's lightweight crew, things are looking up.
They almost beat the girls' squad.
Great, Joe. This looks like gold.
But I had an idea I wanted to run by you about Columbia's compliance with Title IX. I thought you could take a look at what
I've got. Good initiative, kid. Kiki, take a look at this for me.
I got it. Check this for me.
Give it a go once, Otto. Hey, put this in your box, will ya?
Let me know if this is trash.
Uh-huh.
What are you doing still standing there, kid?
Taking in the view. They just give me a story. I need a chance to make a name. Then maybe I get the glory. I want a taste of campus fame. And I could show the school a little something, and I'd be more than a nothing. But it takes more than a reporter or a silly newsroom sorter. It's gonna take someone brave.
Got a fresh one, Lee, another grade complaint. He seems pretty upset.
Oh, great. Just what I need. All right. You got this one, Lee. Eye on the ball. Come on. Hey there, kiddo. What can I do for you?
My essay on Kant and his effect on Radiohead got a B-. I can't get into law school with that.
Radiohead, wasn't he a character on Transformers?
No. It's like he's talking about the categorical imperative in Creep. It's so deep.
Yeah, I can see that.
Lee, you know the university's stance on grade grubbing.
Sorry, kiddo, but there's nothing old Bollinger can do for you. The rules are the rules.
I knew it. You'll never be as chill as Rop.
Shit! That's 0 for 12 on the day, Claire. Now I know how those kids on the basketball team must feel.
Give it time, sir. Besides, you've been neglecting your paperwork.
Oh.
Rupp was always good with paperwork.
It can wait. For Christ's sakes, they won't even let me into Nacho Mama's. I'm unpopular, Claire.
Sir, I hardly think that you're unpopular.
I don't care about you at all. It's what those students think that's gnawing at me. They wouldn't even know me if they saw me. Hello? Students, it's me. President Bollinger. You know, Presbo. Look at me. Know me. Love me. It's useless.
Perhaps if you screamed a little louder.
Oh, that's not the point. They only know me as the old fogey who lulled their hungover asses to sleep at a CC lecture. Maybe I'll get tough with them. Yeah. They don't know I was raised by a pack of wild grizzly bears. Hell, I bet they don't even know I'm black.
Give it time, sir. Give it time.
I've given it enough time. Oh. Look, I've decided to bring in someone else. This guy's a PR genius. He'll give me the New York flair I need.
Sir, I think that's a grave mistake. If you remember when we first arrived in Michigan...
I told you never to mention that state to me.
Drake Martin, at your service.
Howdy, Drake. We weren't expecting you for another couple of minutes. How'd you like a cup of joe?
Certainly.
Claire, 2 cups, extra black.
I'm always a little early or a little late. Puts people on edge, gives me the advantage. Lee, baby, have you thought of cashmere?
Well, to be honest, I've always considered myself more of a wool guy.
Well, we're gonna have to give you more of a Tom Cruise meets Captain Hook look. But really, let's get down to business. I'm here because you need me.
Oh, sure as hell. My image is just...
Sissy, gruff, boobish, laughable, watered down...
Hey, now, I'm not...
Your image, Lee, is hardly defined. The 37% of students who recognize you think you're Quigley's assistant.
Quigley's assistant? Well, I'm gonna bust a cap in someone's ass up in
the... Trust me, Lee! Trust me! I can take you places. Hell, my work speaks for itself. No one took the People's Choice Award seriously until I stepped in. Ted Kennedy only knocked back old duels until I told him to buck up and drink like a real man.
Well, that's quite a portfolio. Mr. Martin, how would you like to be Dean of Public Relations?
Excellent! Dean Martin! Has a nice ring to it.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a lot of changes to announce.
Changes? What are we planning to do?
You've missed the point entirely. It doesn't matter. You just have to make drastic, sweeping announcements that will give you the air of a man with a plan. We can think of the plan later.
I can see it now. Presbo, man with a plan.
We'll start with cutting funding. To sports or activities or drama or the Corps or something. Or better yet, everything. We need the money to play around with if we want to infuse your image with a little spice, with a hint of pizzazz and a dash of bam!
Okay. Cutting funding? I mean, couldn't we start with a bake sale or a car wash on Low Plaza?
It was nice seeing you again, Lee. Give me a call if you wanna.
All right. Look, I'll do anything if it puts me in the spotlight. Mrs. Bollinger always said I'd look great in fur.
Don't worry. It won't be so bad. You might want to change into some more comfortable shoes, though. It's time to shake things up. There's an old saying that a wise man tells his noble king, that the good things you care about don't mean a thing. It's the showy stuff, the body shit, that makes it sell. Well, if you're gonna be a star here, follow me. Come on, Lee, baby, and soon you'll see you make a few changes here and there. But I guess we'll piss off a few students here and there. But shaking things up around here. Before we move on, Lee, we've got to keep the protest quiet to ward off any thoughts of a student riot. So, Lee, what needs to be fixed around here?
Oh, God, well, pretty much everything. I mean, happy students are in the minority.
But we certainly don't have time to deal with minorities. So let's start with this housing crunch.
Well, there's room at St. A's, but we can't...
Great! We're moving all the work study kids in there. Head on in, boys! A few friends here and there. Oh, don't you think that you and me just make the perfect pair? We're shaking things up around here. Let's go down to Dodge. We'll cut a team or two. Girl sports will go first since no one gives a damn.
Hey, I do.
Then we'll make football game attendance required for everyone. Then we'll make Barnard College the new football stadium.
Barnard College is the new football stadium.
Now you're talking. Who needs girls sports?
You can't do that to our sports. We're getting seen demarked. Who do you think you are? This can't be on that dream. Let's tell me, Martin, that this time he's gone to.
Be a star, yeah. Follow me. That's right, Lee, baby. You'll start to see. You make a few changes at some fair. You got services from the Office of Student Affairs. And you see, you're shaking things up around here. Next stop, Broadway bars. From now on, last call, 10:30. Columbia will be a happier place now that everyone will be sober enough to enjoy it.
You can't close down the bars. We're on the mercy margin. You better watch your back. We hope we don't get the urge to throw Dean Martin out. He's under attack.
Ah.
Listen up, folks. We gotta push back everything we got till later this week. I want the whole issue devoted to this Martin guy's death. Human interest stories, campus reactions, ballistic analyses, the works. It's a damn good thing we didn't fill the front page yet, huh?
Yeah, boss, a damn good thing.
I'm gonna need a tabloid shot here of the murder scene. Anything will do, a file photo, a rough sketch, so long as it conveys the human emotions. Tug the heartstrings, but don't rip them out. Ooh, we still need to assign the cover story.
Do you want me to get Ace for you? He's the best we've got.
No, that's all right.
Did I hear my name? Don't worry, boss. You got Ace on the case.
I'm sorry, Ace, but I haven't...
Martin, murder mayhem. Students arm themselves for protection.
The students Ace. Are arming themselves!
Not yet, but once my story
Ace.
Hits the
stand. I'm sorry, Ace, but I need you on the academic beat for later this week.
I'm all done. Academic Senate stalls. Once again, nothing accomplished.
Ace, I still need you there. What if there are new developments?
What are the chances of that, boss?
You're a reporter, Ace. I'm not paying you to ask questions.
Hey, boss, I'm assuming you still want my comic strip.
Of course, Jerry. Even in our darkest hour, laughter will lighten our load.
Laughter? Oh, I better go rework this one.
Joe! Get your ass in gear! Do you think I'm made of patience?
I'm not even supposed to be here for another half hour. Just thought I'd get an early start on my article about the baseball team switching baseball brands.
Oh, drop the balls, Joe. I'm giving you the assassination story.
Oh, this is a real big deal.
Joe, shut up and look me in the face for a second. I know you're young and inexperienced, a new kid on the block. And yes, I know that a story of this magnitude is usually given to a team of reporters, not just one rookie, but there's something about that look in your eyes, Joe. About the confident way you swagger in here every evening that tells me this is the right choice. Don't ask me how, but I know you'll manage to pull something together here.
I'll start right now.
No need to poke through the gory details of something like this. Leave that to the authorities. We barely have time to capture the human aspect. Walk and talk, Joe. Punch that up, Sally! A catchy headline is more important than wasting your time fixing spelling errors.
I won't disappoint you.
Oh, I'm not worried about that. Just do me a favor. If you bite off more than you can chew, spit it out. Timmy! That page needs a chart or a graph or something! Who the hell wants to read a page with just text? You might as well be reading Herodotus. Where was I?
Spitting it out.
Right. There's no sense in hanging on like a golden retriever to a bowling ball. You'll end up lying in the gutter with a broken jaw.
Don't worry about me.
Oh, I'm not worried. Just chew that over for a while. But not too long. I want that story on my desk by midnight tonight.
Walking around on campus.
was feeling more than a bit uneasy. They say, Joe, you've got to take this story. Here's your chance, but it's not that easy. I spent my days as a child watching Dr. Claw up against a penny and brain. Now I'm solving brutal murder. That's not the idea that I had when I came to Columbia.
If you don't solve it, who will? If you don't solve it, who will? If you don't solve it,
shot at spec reporter before I might have resisted, but this chance right here, I've gotta risk it to show the school a little something. Though I really can't be trusting, I'll have to be a brilliant sleuth, seek out the awful truth. I'm sure I can be the man for the job. Columbia, I understand. I'm gonna narrow down the list of suspects, sort out all the subcontext, and I'll be known as a top reporter. If it kills me, I'll solve the murder, and I'll show them that I can be brave.
If you don't solve it, who will? If you don't solve it, who will? Who will?
No one but me.
In Michigan, we didn't have to worry about guns or murder or angry mobs, just Michigan football and our steady union job at the Ford plant. That's it.
Lee, I have Mrs. Bollinger on line 3. She seems pretty upset.
We're going back to Michigan today. No, I don't care. Leave the cat. I'll buy you a new cat. Then I'll buy you a poodle. Women, I'll never understand them. They only care about two things, cats and something else. Are you married, Claire?
No, sir, but I,
I bet the women can't get enough of you, huh?
Sir, that's not exactly...
Oh, modest, modest, modest. You know, back in Michigan, I was the belle of the ball. Oh, Michigan, the air, the trees, the can-do spirit. Why'd I ever leave it behind?
You can't keep living in the past, Lee.
Oh, maybe you're right, but I can try.
What would the people of Michigan think to see you giving up so quickly?
No, you're right. I can't just leave. I can't let the people of Michigan down. But Dean Martin, so much.
What would Martin tell you to do?
He'd probably say, change your clothes. He hated navy blue.
I mean, what would he
say? I know what you mean. He'd want me to forge on. He'd want me to find the murderer. OJ gave up, but I never will. Oh, but I don't even know where to start.
People often go to JJ's place when they need time to think.
Oh, God, no. It smells like a fish concert in there. Claire, get me my address book. I need some time to think. You know, sometimes Presbo wonders. Just wonders what the hell he's doing here.
If I could do it all again, I might have stayed in Michigan. But when in the road of your life there is a fork, who can resist? Who can resist New York? I've got no right to look back now. With all the nice things you've done for me, the students who came to my inauguration to see me, how will I ever thank, how will I ever thank those three? And they think I'm so tough, but underneath all that rough, there's a war inside, and a man who's lied to himself. Now that what's his name is gone, could Lee be the next one? Should I forge on and make this new lead? Should I find the old me? I could do it all again, I might have stayed in Michigan. But when in the road of your life there is a fork, who can resist? Who can resist? Who wouldn't go from Michigan?
How much do you love living in Hogan? Yeah. Monique, what are you doing here?
I saw you across South Lawn and I had to speak.
Are you an idiot? Did you just fail out of surfaces and knots or something? I can't be seen with you.
But Jai, I feel very guilty.
Don't. It's over. And the less we say about it, the better. Now scram!
But Jai.
Are you deaf too? Skedaddle!
Nobody does this to Monique. You'll pay for this. You. Oh, yoo-hoo!
Excuse me, sir?
Hey there, how can I help you?
Hi, Jay Orenduff, right?
Right.
The name's Joe Satchel from The Spectator. I've got some questions about,
I'm sorry. I don't have time to talk right now. I'm in a big rush.
If I could just have a couple of minutes...
I've got to run. I'm Nickel.
I understand. Damn, I've got to be more firm. Mr. Bollinger, sir!
Me? Hey, what's up?
The name's Satchel from The Spec. I've got some questions about Martin's murder.
Okie dokie, I'll shoot the breeze with you for a while.
I see you just came from the crime scene. Have there been any developments in the case?
It's a real tragedy. Mr. Martin was a great man. And a good dancer.
Did he have any enemies?
Well, no, not that I know of. Oh, well, Claire didn't like him too much, but... Well, not that she would. I mean to say that... No, he didn't. Look at the time. I gotta go. It's just...
One more question, sir.
Why did you ask Mr. McGruff over there? He's the head of CU security.
Damn it. I don't have a single quote I can use. I've gotta get McGruff to talk. You, McGruff?
Yeah, well, I ain't, anybody else.
Word is, Bollinger's none too happy about how you've been handling this case.
What? Who told you
that? I was just talking to the big man himself.
Oh, well, come on! How am I supposed to figure anything out? Just by looking around? Jeez!
Well, do you at least have a list of suspects?
Well, Sammy compiled a list of everybody who had a grudge against Dean Martin.
I'd love to get my hands on it.
Yeah, you and I both. Sammy's a great compiler, but he's always losing everything.
Well, Bollinger's gonna go apeshit. You better at least have one suspect.
Well, I have a hunch, but, you wouldn't be interested.
Oh, try me.
No, it's just a guess.
Come on.
Really. No, you'd laugh.
Out with it!
All right! A supervillain, but don't worry! We're gonna set a trap. First, we need to get the city's largest diamond. Then we're gonna put it on display in Butler Library. Then Sammy and I is gonna hide behind the stairs, and when he comes out...
You better keep looking.
Look, I'd be lying to you if I said I thought that we'd find the killer soon. Or at all.
Well, have you noticed anything of interest?
Well, Eddie said he saw a pigeon with one foot. Right, Eddie? I mean, that's pretty interesting. Hey, who'd you say you were anyways? Bollinger's brother?
The name's Joe Satchel from The Spec.
Spec? Damn you, paparazzo! Your kind killed Princess Di! You hoodwinked me good.
That's a nice bulletin board.
Thank you. It just wouldn't be April without the wildflowers.
Is this supposed to be a petunia?
It's a lilac. You don't look like you live in Carman.
No. Shapiro. Ah.
Well, are you visiting someone on the floor? I don't like to be interrupted like this.
I'm here to see you, Monique.
How did you...
I can smell trouble in you. You smell like trouble.
That's very flattering. Look, I've got to get
Do you like your room, Monique?
Sure. It's one of the best in Carman.
One of the best? Seems to me the best damn RA around deserves the best, not one of the best.
Oh, Well, I wouldn't know anything about that. What's there not to love about Carmen?
Oh, I don't know. But it seems you were more than a little upset with a certain administrator.
How did you?
You'll get your turn. You and Jay Orenduff aren't getting along so well, are you? Maybe he couldn't give you the room you asked for because of Dean Martin's new policies. So you ended up here. The top RA stuck in a dismal little rattle, surrounded by freshmen. 10-minute elevator rides just to reach these cinder block walls. So you took matters into your own hands.
Enough! Sure, I was angry with Jay. But I didn't kill anybody.
I didn't say anything about murder.
Oh my God, you were totally hinting at it. So I paddle a few freshmen every once in a while. You try being den mother to a bunch of vomit machines.
You had motive, Monique. Dean Martin must have known about your vigilante RA ways. He thought your rogue cop act wasn't conducive to building community.
Those monsters ripped out all of the giraffes that I had for their doors. Do you know how hard it is to cut down 40 fucking giraffes? It's a lot harder than it seems.
Not to mention the bachelorette pad you would have had if Dean Martin hadn't taken that away, too.
I was going to have a double in Watt all to myself, with a clean bathroom and a nifty kitchen and a view of 1/13th that's just to die for. I was going to cover the whole thing in houseplants and pastels and framed posters. Framed! It was going to be the best 7 months of my life.
And Martin ruined it for you.
What's done is done. I don't need your pity.
Just to get the record straight, where were you when Martin was murdered?
Oh, I wasn't anywhere near there.
Was there anyone with you?
No.
Well, who was the last person you
saw?
Nobody,
nobody.
What do you mean by nobody?
Nobody that day, I mean, so.
This is gonna make for a great headline. Beautiful girl never leaves room.
Do you actually mean that?
No. Sounds fairly boring.
Well, I was lying anyway.
Well, why don't you tell me what really happened that evening, from the beginning?
I was walking over to Wallach to see Jay. He hadn't returned my phone calls for a few days, but I knew he was real busy with fall housing registration, and he has a tough job with lots of paperwork. I used to go surprise him in his office all the time. He was always so happy to see me.
I'm sorry, I really wish I could help you, but under Dean Martin's new policies, the university has every right to commandeer local property and fill half of it with incoming freshmen.
Blaine Randall Alexander III will not stand for this! I didn't become president of St. Anthony's Hall by sitting around and sipping mummy's hot cocoa! The day that our literary society is filled with a bunch of barely weaned charity cases is the day I resign my post.
That's great. I'd like to thank you for coming by and letting me know your concerns. I'm gonna do my best to make something happen, but most of the time, that's not enough.
You haven't heard the last of me. I cannot be shuffled out like some deck of pornographic playing cards!
Come by anytime you need anything. The name's Jay. Now, young lady, why don't you tell me... Monique. Honey, you look beautiful today.
Jay. What the hell is this?
Let's see. Why, this looks like a room transfer form.
Yeah. The transfer to Watt was rejected, Jay. Rejected.
Really? Well, that's news to me.
But you signed the form.
I see hundreds of those things. You don't think I actually read them, do you? That would be hours of work a month.
But you promised me a double in Watt, Jay. You promised.
The final decision isn't up to me, Monique. The computer does
everything.
I
don't want to hear any of your bullshit, Jay. I know the computer doesn't do squat.
Monique.
Yes?
Listen. The Watt transfer didn't work out.
there was a student with rickets, and long story short, she made a miraculous recovery and she gets to keep the room.
But Jen...
Well, what do you want me to do? Tell her she has to commute from the hospital?
Oh, so now I'm the monster.
You're not that bad.
Ow.
The truth is, since Martin arrived, I don't have the leeway I used to. I can't make decisions willy-nilly anymore.
I should have expected that your impotence extended to your work as well.
Oh. Now, Monique, let's not confuse our personal lives with our professional relationship. What's done is done.
What's done?
And I...
But...
I'm really glad you came by to let me know your concerns, Monique. I'm gonna do my best to make something happen.
Jay, this sounds like... the brush off.
Sometimes, appearances aren't deceiving.
Jay, are you still coming to my keynote speaker's a cappella concert? Whoa, 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 whoa! So that's it. That's where my story ends.
Seems to me it's just the beginning.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's your chance to start over. Find someone else.
Sure.
Look, if you're not doing anything tonight... What were you gonna say?
You're a good listener, Joe.
You tell a good story. A good alibi. I'll have to check it with Oren Duff, of course.
Do you have to involve him in this?
Is there any particular reason you're defending him?
When I was in high school, I was just a hall monitor who didn't know the difference between corduroy and chiffon. I was going to come to New York and discover the new glamorous Monique. And 3 years later, I'm still looking.
Try the mirror.
It's easy to make a joke.
Actually, it takes a lot of practice.
Why don't you ever say anything?
Well, I say lots of things.
See, you never mean anything.
I'm a reporter. I'm supposed to ask questions. Look around you.
What?
See what I'm showing you.
Where?
There's so much in this world that we understand. There's so little we don't have a grasp on, and maybe someday I'll have a say on everything, but for the while, love will always be the greatest mystery.
Are you sure you're not just trying to jerk me around?
Why would I do something like that?
Nobody's ever complimented my bulletin board before.
Philistines!
This seems familiar. Another seeking out my love. There's so much in this world that I haven't planned. There's so little I've got a grasp on. And maybe someday I'll for the while.
questions. Sometimes they more than answers can. Maybe someday I'll take a chance. But for the while,
there's only one.
Can I help you? I don't think anyone ordered pizza.
Well, I'm here for the party. I'm an old friend of Blaine's, a classmate from school.
Come right in. Next time you remember to wear a jacket, will you? Blaine, surprise visit from an old Andover schoolmate.
Lawrence, no, Jamal, no, Bradford, my old chum. How could I forget our evenings of cribbage by the fire? It's about time you came by the society. It's been so long since we joked about minorities in the dormitories. Babu, get this man a drink.
My name is Keith.
Oh, is it?
Very well, sir.
Blaine, I really don't think that now is the time
to party, Bradford? Of course it is! Can't you see it's the anything for money party? Look. Grab a stack of fake cash and go crazy. Let me tell you, for $100 fake dollars, those Barnard girls will do pretty much anything.
Oh, enough, Blaine. I'm not your school chum.
But Bradford...
The name's Joe Satchel from the Spec.
Well, I thought you looked like a public school kid. Our lawn needs some mowing if you want some extra pocket money.
You! What are you doing here?
Blaine, you never invite us over, so we thought we'd surprise you. I love what you've done with the place. Very Chelsea.
Blaine, it's grander than I could have ever imagined. Where are the billiards rooms you're always talking about? I hear the tables are regulation size. It would be fantastic for
you know St. Hayes policy. No jacket, no drink. Now run along. But yes, thank you.
I am wearing a jacket.
Well, I haven't even used my money yet.
Yes, we'll chit-chat later, ladies.
Don't forget about...
You know how some people are. You buy them one drink and suddenly they're your best friends.
Cut the bullshit, Blaine. I'm here to ask you a couple of questions about Martin's murder. Everyone knows your rep. You'll do anything to get your way.
So I like the finer things in life, my boy. If having an Indian manservant is a crime, well, then I'm guilty.
Very guilty.
You couldn't handle Martin's radical ways, could you? He had dreams of expanding student housing so that no poor soul would be stuck in Ween. Your boys' club would be filled with a bunch of plebes. Oh, the horror.
I don't pay $50,000 a year and give up my firstborn so some vagabond on financial aid can move in like Scott Baio in Charles in Charge. St. Anthony's is a literary society, not a shelter. For Christ's sakes, half of those schmoes don't know the difference between Johnny Walker Blue and Johnny Walker Black.
What's going on here, Blaine?
Oh, nothing, Madison. Go back to your gossip. This is grown-up talk.
You have some explaining to do, Blaine Randall. Where were you last night? You ran off looking like some sort of preppy werewolf.
I'm sorry, I had an emergency. I, I really can't discuss my whereabouts right now, Madison. The society has some mandatory gentlemen's events.
What about blowing off my keynote speaker's concert? Was that mandatory too?
Honey, you know how your a cappella political humor bores me.
But Blaine, it was my breakout performance. I was playing Donald Rumsfeld, the leading part. The crowd was just blowing up.
Yes, where were you last night, Blaine? Phyllis Commoner's Inn.
If you have something to say, tell it to me straight. You can search every nook and cranny. The truth is, you have nothing on me. Nothing!
I can't take this anymore! We're through, Blaine! You're just so damn dubious!
Now, Madison, let's not do anything rash.
I'm leaving!
It's a shame, Blaine. Darn shame. She seemed like a sweet girl.
Oh, you people will never understand the life of a St. A's boy. Oh, how I toss and I turn in my sleep. I wake up to Babu, ready to fluff the sheep. It's nearly 4 o'clock. I've missed tea again. So I place on my robe and blanket my tonsils with scotch. Oh, today I'm just too sad to gloat, too unhappy for a day on the boat. Till a tad later, brothers. Oh, Joseph, why must I be treated any differently from my contemporaries just because I'm ultra fortunate? You see, I really wish I was one of them. You see, I too would want to eat at Lerner, ride the subway, maybe drink a Budweiser Light, watch football with the boys, then say, hey chaps, let's go to the West End bar tonight. Get a job, do my taxes, fly in economy class, whoa, shove a gap, listen to rap. Well, on second thought, no, but throw away my Lacoste. Except I could never do that to dear old mummy and daddy. No, I couldn't ever embarrass the family money. No, I wouldn't. No, I couldn't ever come clean. Though you're never too wealthy to dream. Now do you understand my plight? It's not just a midterm malaise. You see, if I wasn't anybody, I could do my laundry, live in a dormitory, sleep with just one girl a night. Why can't I vote for a Democrat and feel that I've done something right? Mow the lawn, wait in line, have the bar tab not be on me. Dine at White Castle and not be an asshole. Then I'd finally be free and do away with my tie. I'd be thrilled to comply. Except I could never do that to dear old daddy and mummy. And especially not to daddy's secretary, Bunny. I wouldn't, no, I couldn't ever come clean. Though you're never too wealthy to
touching, Blaine. Touching.
You understand my plight?
No. I think you're hiding something. No. Don't think I won't get to the bottom of this.
I'm not hiding anything. Oh, sure, I have one pair of pants from the Old Navy, but I don't really deny that.
Why were you so quick to show those dorks out, Blaine? They seem like nice people.
Hardly.
Well, maybe I'll just ask them myself. You'd be surprised what people will say to see their name in print.
Now, wait a second, Joseph. I've committed no crime, but there is a little something I'd prefer kept out of the society pages, if you know what I mean. Perhaps we could keep this a gentleman's secret.
As I frequently do, this evening I made my way down Broadway Avenue. My destination was a quiet little retreat in the McBain dormitory. I took great pains to make sure that no one would recognize me, even traveling in a clever disguise. My plan went off without a hitch, until I reached the building's lobby.
Blaine? Blaine, old boy, what are you doing in this shithole?
Oh, I'm just dropping off some clothing for the charity drive.
Ah, I failed to see the irony, but I'm sure it's there.
Yes, well, they're quite heavy, so...
Blaine, is there something wrong? You don't seem yourself.
Oh, it's nothing, Theodore, nothing at all. I'm just a little on edge. Nothing a few shots of Courvoisier won't take care of.
Well, we're going down to Disney World. We're all going to dress up like Mickey Mouse and chase some stray cats. Come with.
I think I'll pass. Madison and I are going to the opera tonight.
Well, suit yourself. The opera is always very... Watch where you're going, hussy!
Oh, you didn't see anything! You didn't see shit!
But I just did see you! You were walking right in...
You saw nothing, tight ass! And if anyone asks you, Kelly was at the height! Now close your eyes if you know what's good for you!
Please, let's not get carried away here! My skin is very dry and sensitive! So long!
The coast is clear. I've been waiting all week for this moment, and it's finally here! August!
Kazam! Oh, how we have missed your mighty sword and indomitable spirit!
Shut up and take these! What did I tell you about coming to my parties?
But you're so cute when you're surprised. Anyway, let's get this game started. Samantha! Get your elf ass in here!
You better not be pulling my chain again. I've been itching for this moment all day.
Oh, I feel like I can finally breathe again. Dungeons and Dragons, you fill the void in my wealthy soul!
Blaine, I've got a table all set up, but did you bring everything we need?
Yes, of course. 10-sided dice, 12-sided dice, and your Dungeon Master screen. I wish you wouldn't leave this stuff at my place.
Blaine, you're so paranoid.
You could never understand. My whole life is a lie. Days of dry martinis and caviar. Nights of, well, dry martinis and caviar. I'm caught in an insufferable melancholy. But in these brief moments of respite, these dwindling twilight hours, I can escape that horrid nonsense. I can forget about the V-neck sweater vests, proper fork etiquette, wondering whether you tip a butler, and doing all that coke just to be like the other guys.
But I don't understand, Blaine. It always seems like you're living the American dream.
No. It's just as I told my Indian manservant as he served me my mid-morning juice. Babu, I'm unhappy.
Maybe we better just get started.
Yes.
Okay.
At once.
All right. We left off 3 floors down in the sacred temple of Kalpana. You, Kazam, the barbarian warrior, are holding off 4 goblins with your mighty broadsword of fire. You, Grenix, the clever Elven sorceress of Weejaws, has just been wounded by a poisoned arrow.
I cry out in pain and cast a spell of blindness on the river nymph.
Cherish every moment! Coach
coach says it doesn't matter if we lose every game, so long as we try real hard.
You look like you try real hard.
I try a lot harder.
No, he doesn't. Just ask him why he won't shower with the rest of us.
You must be Kelly.
That's right. And I'm busy.
Too busy to talk to an old friend who saw you outside of McBain the other day? Ooh, you seemed real upset.
Guys, give me a sec.
Douche.
I've never seen you at happy hour, and I'm here every night.
The name's Joe Satchel from the Spec.
Let's get this over with. All the cute frat boys are out tonight, and I really don't have time for you, Murphy Brown.
As you've probably heard, Dean Martin has been murdered.
I heard. It's a damn shame. I was about to cry, but then a pipe boy bought me a kamikaze. How can you say no?
Glad you're spending your time here so well.
I came to Columbia for the social life, not to be bogged down by some books written by some dead white men.
Too many dead white men? I'm not so sure you're not part of the problem.
Are you accusing me? Hey, Janine, where'd you wake up this morning? Let's do dinner.
Fact is, I don't know you, but word on the street is you hated Dean Martin more than anybody.
So? I hate a lot of people, but unfortunately, they don't usually die.
Tell me, where were you when Martin was murdered?
I got so fucked up on Tanqueray, I can't even remember.
Don't waste my time, Kelly. I'm on a deadline. Who did you see? Where did you go?
Oh, well, there was a party.
Where was the party, Kelly? Where was the big bash?
Narrow hallways and, would you look at the time? It's almost Joe Millionaire. I better get
you
out of here.
You didn't answer my question, Kelly. Where was the party? EC, Hogan, Ruggles? You like those narrow hallways, don't you?
I don't have to tell you shit.
You've told me enough shit. I want facts.
You got my story.
You want a story? I'll tell you a story. About a young girl who lets her temper get the best of her. About a mad woman who can't control her wild side. I think you're that person. And here's what I think happened. It must have started out like any other evening in your so-called life. You were probably sitting in a bar or a cafe or outside Lerner. Yeah, it was outside Lerner, wasn't it? You were standing there laughing it up with a friend, probably planning a night out on the town, only you never got that far. This night was different, wasn't it?
Tonight's gonna be so bumpin', I'm gonna get my swerve on. Damn, feeling like a loose cannon tonight.
I know, okay, I heard that the Heights is having a 2-for-1 special on margaritas with fake IDs only. It is gonna be so hot.
Listen, we should get going. I'm after a piece of that fine-ass bouncer, and I'm not about to wait in line tonight.
I know the owner, okay?
Don't you know when to shut your mouth? You're like some seas boy lit hum, blabbering about Jane Austen like he banged her. Gets me all fired up.
Damn, Kelly. Damn. You are just so crazy. Sometimes you're just
hey,
scary.
Hey, ladies. What's... Oh, jeez, Kelly. Can I join you two?
I'm not your babysitter.
Oh, thank you.
Gerald, I am so angry with you.
Is this about last Thursday? Because I can explain, okay? My mother caught SIDS.
Sudden infant death syndrome?
It runs in the family.
Are you talking out of your ass or out of your face? We are going to the Heights now.
Okay. I don't think we can go to the Heights.
Gerald, okay. You're going to have to come up with a better line than that to get me to come back to your room.
Like I did last week.
Didn't you hear? All the shops on Broadway have to close down at 10:30 p.m. The Heights and everything else is closed.
Okay. You know my feelings on prohibition.
Yeah, well, look, Cornette's complained about all the people puking in their bathrooms, so Columbia decided to shut it all down. It's totally gonna backfire.
Listen here, wet nap. You better tell me who's behind this shit.
I don't know, Kelly. You seem pretty upset.
This is pudding. But I'm a busy girl, and I've got a lot of stuff to do, so if you don't tell me right now, I'm going to shove this
okay.
Head
all right,
so
all right, all right.
Far.
It was Dean Martin. It was Dean Martin.
Okay.
We just don't want you to do anything crazy, Kelly.
Crazy?
Yeah, crazy.
I'm not crazy. No, you're not crazy. I mean, do you think they'd sell me this gun if I was crazy?
Okay, Kelly, You have, like, totally lost it. So just, put the gun away.
I'm gonna show this punk-ass administrator how we roll in Morningside Heights. And if that means popping a cap in him, well, I'm not squeamish.
Okay. Kelly, I know that even you would not, like, shoot a guy.
Oh, but Janine, nobody knows what they're capable of till it happens.
Okay.
Like, I don't know if I'm capable of killing the bitch who rats me out.
Okay, we'll keep quiet, we promise.
That's how I like it. No. You got it all wrong. I probably shouldn't be telling you this. Damn, I definitely shouldn't be telling you this. Okay, look. You've got to promise this won't get out. I'm not the party girl everyone thinks I am. The truth is, I wasn't going to a party that night at all. I had an orgo midterm coming up. So I went to Butler.
I'm home.
There's a keg on the fourth floor.
That's cool, but don't you have exams? I mean, I hear some of those people do.
You should totally come with us, man. It's gonna be hot. Half a John J. 12's up there. Alex already puked in the ancient Greek room. Yeah.
Sounds pretty cool, Gerald. Let's see if I can check it out.
I'm only here for the chicks. Smart guys are totally in. And with the pickings here, I don't know where to begin. Because I'm reading it, they know me that it's not happening here as the smokers. I make my home in Butler.
Really clearly lately, you know, everything's sort of starting to fall into place for me.
What are you talking about?
My thesis, what else? It's almost done, it's almost perfect. It just needs a smidgen more work and then it'll be there. What? I know, Mom. I know, shut up. I'm still gonna graduate summa cum laude and be perfect. Shut up, Mom, I know.
Nick, maybe you should Take a break from Butler. You've been here for 48 hours straight.
Oh, I know. I just need a few more Red Bulls, that's all. And maybe an eensy, little more Ritalin. It's not like I use it a lot. Sharp, Nick. Focused on the goal. I'm addicted to drugs. My room's infested with bugs. I'm addicted to instant messenger. I thought about religion, but there's only one proper fix to my problems. So, I make my home at Butler. La, 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 la.
Hands up!
Damn it. Hello, kid. I didn't know Bible study met here.
Ace! I don't suppose you'd care to tell me what you're doing up here on the roof.
No, you're right, kid. I don't care to explain.
Well, that's tough.
I've got just as much right to be here as you do.
Which is none.
Let's be reasonable. You want security crawling up both our butts?
Maybe I'm tired of this squeaky clean image. Try me. What were you doing at the crime scene this morning?
I should have had this story, Joe. Celia was a fool to give it to you. The only scoop you'll get is that Haagen-Dazs.
Doesn't suit me, Ace. I'm lactose intolerant.
Big story. Lot of glory. If anybody deserved a shot at it, it was me. Not some rookie sports reporter.
Girls lacrosse is a lot more complicated than it seems. I mean, on the surface it looks a lot like field hockey, but in fact... Wait. You've been investigating!
Ace is on the case. The crime scene was the best place to start. And now that I've explained why I was poking around, I think I'll be going.
Not yet.
The thing is, Joe, I'm supposed to have tea with Kofi Annan. He's a real stickler about punctuality.
You'll have to risk it. Why'd you hightail it to the roof, Ace?
Because an ugly little man was following me.
But why were you so anxious to get over here to Carmen in the first place?
I'm courting a girl on the second floor. You wouldn't believe what those Orthodox girls do for fun.
Bullshit. Bullshit.
No, really, Joe. Sometimes they don't even care if the meat is kosher.
Security! Security!
Shut
Security!
Up! Shut up! Shut up! All right. I've got a hot lead.
Are you gonna spit it out, or do you need another yank on the chain?
This keychain
I found it at the crime scene. I guess your keen reporter eyes must have missed it. It does seem insignificant, like my adopted mother or redheaded.
But how did you get from the keychain to this door?
It's got a skeleton key on it for one of the floors in common.
An RA's key.
The key stays with me, Pipsqueak. I'll see you in the office, Joe. Oh, and remember, one cream, two sugars.
I need to talk to Celia right away.
She's in a meeting.
Well, this is important.
So's the meeting.
Well, this is more
Joe,
important.
Joe, where the hell have you been? Did you ever finish the story?
Well, I've got a copy right here, but to be honest with you, I just...
I never asked you to be honest. I asked for a story.
Well, you got both.
The story and you?
Oh. No, honesty.
Oh. I never much cared for it.
Look, Celia, this story, it's all right, and I'm damn glad you gave it to me, but I can't help but feel that I've missed something.
Yeah. Your deadline. It was supposed to be in an hour ago.
Oh, Christ!
I'm sorry, kid. We had to run another version. You know how it is.
Oh, this isn't funny.
I'm sorry, Joe. We sent the issue to the printers an hour ago. Oh, don't worry. Ace wrote a solid piece on the Martin murder. Seems to have narrowed it down to some R.A. Monique or Monica or something else bland and innocent.
Monique? Does he really think that... Ace is jumping to conclusions. I should have written this story!
Oh, relax, Joe. You'll get another shot. We're not playing Russian roulette.
But this Monique girl, even
oh,
if she did
do it... Oh, forget about her,
it...
Joe. The cops will straighten it out.
Doesn't add up. Something somebody said really got me to thinking about it.
Don't get too specific on me, kid.
Sorry. It's just that I was on the roof of Carmen...
Oh, cut it out, Joe. You're talking my ear off. A pretty boy like you ought to know when to shut up and show off your personality. Is this your first big story?
You know it is.
Make yourself comfortable. Look, I know how it is. My first big story was back in 98 when the sundial was stolen. Here I was, still wet behind the ears, and I took it on myself to find the goddamn thing. How could anyone hide a 6-ton granite ball, Joe? I spent a week turning over every rock in the city. Sure, there aren't many rocks, but they're pretty far apart. Point is, you see the sundial out there today? Uh-uh. Everyone falls on their face, kid. Even me. You just gotta swallow it. Sure, it leaves a bitter taste, but whiskey and time wash that away.
I'm not a very patient man.
Tough. I'm gonna need you on the Bollinger beat, Joe. Lots more administrative news than there was last year. I have a source that tells me those leather chairs in Lerner are made out of donkey hide. That's where we need our top reporters.
Well, next week I'd
today,
be
happy- Joe, I'm not gonna leave you fishing in this empty pond because no one's biting.
If I could just have one more day,
what?
I know-
Give up your chance at moving up on this paper just to satisfy your misplaced curiosity. Look, kid, I like the cut of your jib. I like the way you wear those pants. But I don't like those little creases next to your eyes that tell me you're just not dropping this. What you need is a breather, a little time to think things over.
While I'm thinking things over, this Monique girl's gonna be run down by an angry mob.
Relax, Joe. Ace seems to think she killed Dean Martin.
Ace has been wrong before.
You know, if I didn't know you better, I think you'd fallen for this girl.
Don't be ridiculous. I just don't want to see her name dragged through the mud.
I was wrong to give you the story, kid. You'll never be a reporter with that kind of attitude.
Just got a copy back from the printers. Cold-blooded common killer disappears without a trace.
Disappears without a trace? Why would she do
that? Seems pretty suspicious to me. She moved out of her dorm today. Nobody knows where she went.
Joe, where are you going? I need you to cover the donkey leather story.
Cover your own asses. I'm gonna go find Monique.
Thank you.
use being here, surrounded by fear. Yes, it's time to get out. And I'm done being played by reporters and Jay. They think they're right, and they might be. There's so much in this world that I don't understand. Why can't any of these boys be a man? Isn't any of this going as planned? Walking around on campus, feeling more than a bit uneasy. I have got to go, I have got to let her know. Walking around on campus, feeling more than a bit uneasy. I have got to go, I have got to let her know.
Less attention. Counting the steps on the road back to Michigan. It won't be that bad. I guess it won't be that hard. If I could do it all again.
Yeah!
get it. What the hell do you think you're doing?
I'm walking home, Joe. Every now and then, even I need to sleep in a real bed.
Have you seen what it's like over there on campus? I haven't seen people this crazy since they started charging for Sweet and Low at 212.
It's unfortunate, yes, but it's not our problem.
Celia, you've got to print a retraction.
The keychain was hers, right? She had reason to hate Dean Martin. She fled the scene, she moved out on the last day, and now no one knows where she is.
Celia, you published this story! There wouldn't be any mob if you didn't give them someone to blame! These people want to know what to think. Tell them jeans aren't cool anymore and they'd burn their diesels in a heartbeat.
Joe, you got it all wrong. The spec isn't here to interfere. We're a newspaper, not a newsletter. Fact is, we don't do anything. We just publish the facts. The mob can jump to their own conclusions.
They jump to your conclusions.
Semantics.
Celia, do you really think that Monique killed Dean Martin?
Doesn't matter what I think, Joe. I'm just here to observe.
That's the first time I've ever heard you say that.
Look, maybe Ace was a little irresponsible, but a sweet boy like you shouldn't go beating yourself up about it. You missed your deadline, so we had to print Ace's story instead. We couldn't leave the front page blank, Joe. People just aren't used to that kind of artsy crap. It's not your fault.
I'd only finished an hour earlier. Oh, if I hadn't been so intent on finding the murderer, I didn't want the glory so much. I could have done my job and written a story. I feel so drained.
You're cute when you're exhausted.
I've been running around all day. I haven't had a moment to think.
It's late, Joe. You look tense. You need to take a breather, relax.
Maybe you're right.
You'll feel better if you sit down for a little while. Say, Melinda's sick and she was looking for someone to fill in for her on the restaurant beat. What say you and I go down to this little Indian place on 89th, have dinner and drinks, and talk about just any little thing?
Well, that's a sweet offer. It really is, but...
Oh, don't think of it as an offer. It's an assignment.
It's just that I've got some Calvin and Hobbes reading to do for CC.
Joe, you're too good at telling the truth. A lie like that sticks out from the pack. Besides, dinner with me and you forget all about stuffy philosophy.
When you put it like that.
Dress up nice and don't wear those shoes. Dinner's on the spec. Sit down. You are something of interest to me. Don't you feel it, Joe? Don't you see? No. I was once a measly low end like you. But I know exactly how to get old Celia through the damn glass ceiling at the spec. A little action made directly to the top. A bit of feeling and healing and knowing how to drop a hint. But when push came to shove, I wasn't the one begging for more. And I learned as much about the bedroom as I did about the newsroom floor. Oh. Listen to me, little honey. This game ain't about news or money. It's about fees. It's about these. It's about paying your dues. Come on, Joe, sweetheart. What have you got to lose? Oh, Joey, you know I'm not the chief for nothing. And I don't do nothing for nothing. So you must be sipping drinks at Chief's table for something pumpkin. You know I'm not the chief for nothing. And I don't do nothing for nothing. So you must be sipping drinks at Chief's table for something pumpkin. You know I'm not the chief for nothing. And I don't do nothing for nothing. Oh.
Mr. Orenduff.
Call me Jay.
I'll stick with Mr. Orenduff.
Do I look like somebody's father to you? You're not here to file a paternity suit, are you?
Are you? Because I'm sterile.
Name's Joe Satchel from the Spec, and I need information.
Well, the URH website.
Do you like working here?
Sure. I like the students, and they like me. We shoot the shit about everything. Football, tits, vodka. I'm always game.
Are you gonna miss it?
What do you mean?
When I call Lutumsky and tell him you've been sleeping with students.
Oh. Sure, I've screwed my share of freshman girls. And if you're a junior guy who lives in Ween, well, I've pretty much screwed you too. But hey, we're all still friends, right?
Quit stalling! I don't have time for this.
All right, look, I'm sure we can arrange something. How would you like an EC suite all to yourself? I can even make Ryder Strong your roommate.
I'm not into your crooked deals. I want information on Monique. No.
So she told you. Just like a pig to squeal. I haven't seen her since the day Martin was shot. She was walking out that door when I heard the gun.
She was here at 6 o'clock?
I told you once.
Then you'll tell me again if I ask you, Duff.
I'd move too if half the campus wanted to kill me. Lucky for this guy, that's not a problem. Too bad, though. She was... Residence life was so important to her. Not a day went by she didn't obsess over decorating her room, or paddling her residence, or rehearsing with the keynote speakers, or taking her bowling ball for
a walk.
The
keynote speakers?
Yeah, the political comedy a cappella group. She loved their clever puns about the Washington scene and their witty banter between songs.
Thanks, Duff. Gotta run. We need to talk, Blaine.
Who is it?
It's Joe Satchel from the Spec.
Oh. Well, can I fix you a drink? Top shelf, of course.
I'll have the champagne of beers.
The what?
Miller High Life.
Right. So, what brings you back to the society?
I need to talk to your girlfriend, that fair Georgia Peach Madison.
And what do you want her for, Carmen San Diego? If I recall correctly, you weren't too cordial to Blaine last time you saw him.
I don't like you, Blaine, and I never have. But I need to talk to Madison right away.
I'm sorry, Joseph. I just don't see why I should help you. If you're quite finished, call me.
I don't know what's thicker, your fakey accent or that skull.
What? I don't have to stand for this!
Oh, you don't have to stand, but I think sitting would be difficult with whatever it is you've got shoved up your ass!
How dare you!
First you tell me your dirty little secret! That you've been shaking 12-sided dice instead of dry martinis, and now you tell me to scram?
I see. I've dealt with your kind before. There was the affair of the carpenter who saw too much. I'm sure we can come to some kind of equitable arrangement. What'll it be? A new bicycle, perhaps? Or a razor scooter? The kids love them.
I just need to see your girlfriend.
Ah, it all becomes clear. Madison! Oh, Madison, dearest! I must warn you, Joseph, she's a strong woman. In the mold of Margaret Thatcher. At first, she may resist sleeping with you, but once I explain, and she... Ah, there she is!
If you're drunk and messing around with that Civil War raffle again, I swear...
The newsy. No subscriptions this month, thanks.
Madison, honey, let's show the good chap some old-fashioned St. A's hospitality. You know our motto, mi casa es tu casa.
I'm looking for your choir mate, Monique. From the keynote speakers?
And I'm looking for a dog that can talk. Good luck to both of us!
Honey, Joseph has me over his knee, rather like the old headmaster after I stole those hard candies. You simply must help him.
Blaine, dearest, I am under considerable duress, and you have seen how campus sentiment has turned on our maligned, misunderstood Monique. I can't give her location out to just anyone, especially not to a member of the Penny Press.
I'm sure the gentleman has only the best intentions.
That's hardly my concern.
Barbarian warrior.
Madison, I have something to tell you.
What
something,
is it?
Something I've been hiding from you, from everybody.
What is it, Blaine? You can tell me anything.
I'm not who you thought I was.
I know! I've already figured it out!
What?
I know you're leading a double life! You're an assassin for the Japanese mafia!
No, Madison. I could only dream. You see, the only things I'm killing are dragons and wizards in the land of make-believe. Yes, I'm addicted to a game of dice and sorcery!
A game? Blaine, this is all a little hard to digest. I'm at a loss for words.
Madison, I'm so ashamed. But don't you see? I'm still the same yacht-riding, arrogant prick I've always been.
Blaine, if I don't tell this rude reporter everything, he's gonna tell everybody about you.
I'm afraid so.
We've wasted enough time. Where can I find Monique?
She's staying with a friend down at NYU in their Broom Street dormitory.
Huh. She would feel safe at a safety school.
Oh, that's right. Toodles. I mean, it's funny, isn't it? Touché.
It's vintage!
I can't believe they put so much foam in my latte.
Donnie Dorkin is playing the film for him now.
Hey, man, have you heard the new White Stripes album?
Hey, we can study later. Let's go try my tongue ring.
Jeff? What are you doing here?
Oh, Monique, I came here to find you. I never thought you'd end up in a place like this.
It's not so bad.
No! Oh!
Oh. Wait for me! Wait!
Oh, Jeff. I'm so glad to see your face. It's so clean.
You could have called me, Monique. I could have found you somewhere to stay.
Everyone was so incensed, I didn't even know if you'd want to talk to me.
Of course I wanted to.
I couldn't bear those horrible leering stares. They all thought I was a glamorous yet dangerous murderess. I had to leave.
On the day of the murder, Monique?
Oh, is that why you're here? Because I look suspicious?
No. I know you didn't do it.
Do you trust me, Jill?
Of course I do. But it doesn't look good running away like that.
I wasn't running from you.
Maybe you should have.
What's that supposed to mean? Are you dirty?
No, you've been treated bad. Who says I'm any better?
I trust you, Joe. Put your arms around me.
Here?
Now I can show you.
Sure.
The great part about love is you don't have to understand. There's so little we have a grasp on and maybe someday I'll take a chance before the wild.
There's only one way to solve.
Little paper like that.
Oh, I'll find the murderer, Monique. I'll clear your name.
I'm never going back there.
Don't say that.
I'm transferring, Joe. Special circumstances. I'll have the key to my new room by the end of the week, and I can always pick up my clown tap dancing lesson.
What?
It's like regular tap dancing, except the shoes are bigger.
Your key. Did you lose your key in the last few days?
Oh, yes. I felt my bag moving, and then I looked, but no one was there, but I heard this whistling.
What were they whistling?
La 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 la. La 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 da 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 ba.
Ace! Ace is the... I know who. Oh, but the spec office is not safe.
Go to Bollinger. He seems harmless. Oh,
thanks, Monique. I've got to run. It's Joe. Listen, you've got to leave the spec office. I don't care where, just go. I've got to see Bollinger. President Bollinger!
Nice to see you, Joe. Come on in, you're letting in a draft.
What have I done to deserve this? Presbo tried so hard to
Sorry, Bollinger. You are just so boring.
Look, I know how I must seem to you. Brutish and bursting with testosterone. But underneath there's a tender flower with a heart of gold aching to come forth.
Oh, keep quiet.
Let him go. This is between us.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with that.
I'm sorry, Joe, but I need you both here.
I wasn't after you, Celia. I thought Ace was the one that
Ace was just a pawn. He couldn't iron a wrinkle-free shirt without calling his mother. I needed him to frame Monique.
How could you? Can't believe I slept with a murderer.
Joe, don't you see? I did it for the spec. It was the biggest story since Eisenhower fought that bear. The headlines, Joe. Think how many papers we could have sold.
The papers are free.
That's not the point. I wanted you with me. I wanted you to break the story with me. We'd supply enough evidence to get you to write an incriminating story and then arrange it so the suspect conveniently kills herself. After that, there wouldn't even be a trial.
She was innocent.
Oh, she didn't kill Dean Martin, but she sure wasn't innocent. You thought she was capable of murder, but you were too deep in love to bite. So we had to supply our own story.
The keychain is hardly proof of murder.
Oh, who cares? You would have had the glory. You would have solved the case. We'd both be making our own headlines. It's not too late, Joe.
Bollinger knows too. We'd have to kill him.
Go, Presbo! Go, Presbo!
Hey,
go,
hey, go, hey, go. Hey, hey! Get down! You get down! Down! Yeah. Yeah. That's right. There's always someone else to frame, Joe. There's always some way we can spin the events.
After you kill Bollinger, who's left to frame?
Ace. Ace is downstairs. I can call him.
You spin good, Celia. Like a drunk sixth grader on a merry-go-round. But you're crazy if you think you're gonna leave this building after killing two people. You can't solve every problem with a murder-suicide.
Oh, you'd be surprised. Have you forgotten everything that happened between us, Joe? I don't want to hurt you. I want to walk out of here together, as heroes.
You're asking me to forget everything I've ever cared about.
Fame? Success? I'm not asking you to forget about those things, Joe. Just that arbitrary little line we call decency.
Wasn't a lie, Celia. Between us?
No, Joe. You're the only one I wouldn't frame. Well, Joe, looks like it got the glory after all, huh?
No, Celia. Just some nasty stains.
The headline, Joe. The headline.
Brilliant woman makes tragic mistake.
No, no!
Yeah, someone's been shot in my office. No, no, not Kava. Send a real ambulance. I think she's dead. Yeah. No, you're right. Kava's fine. Yeah. All right, you have a nice day. Okay. Well, you're a hero, kid.
Wish I could go back to being a reporter.
You're a reporter? You won't mention my state, will you? It was a ruse. I was just about to pounce on her. Lucky for her, you shot her, because I was raised by bears.
Yeah, real lucky break.
Well, it seemed like you knew her.
We worked together.
An office romance? Those always end badly. No?
No.
Well, look on the bright side. I mean, you'll be the talk of the town now.
It's just the cameras and the questions.
So you're saying you wish someone else had caught her?
Wish I'd never been involved.
So what I'm hearing is, if someone else took the credit, the blame, for this deed, that you'd be pleased.
As punch.
She's so dead! What happened?
Well, we were having this talk about...
I shot her! She killed Dean Martin and she was going to kill me. This young gentleman's a reporter. He got here before you.
We were pumping a stomach in Carmen. Sorry we were late.
Tequila?
Always is. Yeah.
I'm sorry, I can't grant your paper an interview now. I'm too shaken up. Perhaps later tonight, I'll grant your paper an exclusive.
You caught her, President Bollinger? You're gonna be a hero!
Sir, is it true?
Who says nothing exciting ever happens in Columbia?
Mother always said, if you wanna be the one that they look at, take the gun. Into your own hands. Well, I did it, now it's done, and I'm finally the one they look up to. They look up to me. It's a case of here and now.
kind of glory. Now that it's all done, I have still got some things to take care of. Students, faculty, you've got problems that I'm aware of. And I'll solve them all right away and make it a brand new day for Columbia University. Throw the past away for now, bang, let's sing hooray and shout. Let's take a student poll. Presbo. Oh, you're special. What a great feeling! This rock and kind of glory.
Hey, you know, even with Seer you gone, we could still use a reporter like you around, Joe.
Thanks, but no.
I mean, if you ever reconsider or just want to grab a bite to eat or something. Monique, what are you doing uptown?
I came to find you, Joe. I heard that somebody was shot in Bollinger's office, so I knew that you...
Yep, I got there just in time to get an exclusive.
But, Joe, you...
That's right. I really lucked out getting there just in time to see Bollinger burst into action.
But what about all of the whistling and the eyes and the tracking me down and the stern questions and the...
That'll be our little secret. All that doesn't matter now. Bollinger solved the murder. He needed it more than I did.
But, Joe, you deserve...
I cleared your name, didn't I?
Sure.
And if I'd solved the murder, too, I'd be out there somewhere, sweating bullets under the flashbulbs and stammering out a bunch of rehearsed answers to a sea of dark faces instead of standing here. With you. Looking into your eyes.
Oh, Joe.
So you're moving back uptown, right?
Everywhere I go, I smell Jay's raunchy musk. The dormitories reek of him.
So let's move off campus.
What? Jay never told me I could do that.
Sure you can. It's a little more expensive, but nobody pees in the showers.
That sounds wonderful.
Let's go.
Don't you have some sort of editor thing to do now?
Nope. I quit.
You're done being a reporter?
Well, I'm done working for an operation that cares more about Novi's haircut and alumni donations than the truth.
Maybe things have changed.
Jeffrey, you illiterate bungler! Stop wasting your time on copy editing and hand in your guesses for the pick box!
Maybe not.
You know, Joe, sometimes I wonder why a star reporter like you would want to be with a girl like me.
You are the best damn girl in all New York. At least the best that's, at least the best that's. Just been taught. If only I could just have seen then I would have avoided this whole mess. But there's no other way but the hard way. See, she knows.
Mom and Dad is here, the truth is I've got to let you know that I love Dungeons and Dragons. And this is my Dungeons and Dragons friend.
August.
How could this have happened to us?
Well, Plain, you're still our son and us.
You and your friend are still welcome at the club.
There was no other way but the hard way.
I'm so glad I stayed in New York City. Michigan is pretty shitty. And now I'm surrounded by students that love me.
She's his new administrator. She's a student and I already hate her.
Should have hired me before. You know, shouldn't let him bust you around.
I guess there will be no other way but the hard way.
Look at what I've become. A little murder never hurt no one. Now I finally see it. I can't help but believe it. In my days as a Colombian, there's so many times I've wanted to run to community college. So why don't I follow through? I guess there's no other way but the hard way. Yes, there's no other way but the hard way.
Well, who wouldn't go from anywhere to New York?
Thank you.